What's going on YouTube, GSNordic here. So in today's video we're going to discuss about the current status of the iOS jailbreaking and on which version I recommend it to stay if you're waiting for a jailbreak. I'm going to start, by the way, with giving a huge shout out to this guy in here on Twitter, Merculus, who is actually interested in iOS dual booting and iOS security. Now he's very interested on that matter. I talked to him, he's a very nice guy. So if you're interested in iOS security and iOS dual booting, as well, you should go ahead and follow him. He is actually the dude who told me about the iPound DFU, of course him and Jonathan Seals in here. But yeah, if you're interested in iOS dual booting and you want to work with somebody on various projects, go ahead, follow him, he's a very nice guy. Now I'm going to start with the fact that yes, there is currently no jailbreak for iOS 11 and for iOS 10.3.3, 10.3.2 and 10.3.1. That's something you probably already know unless you're very new in here. But there is a very, very interesting thing you need to keep in mind. That is the version you're currently on and the vulnerabilities that are available for it. Yes, there will never be a jailbreak for the latest and greatest, at least not in the modern days of iOS. The odds to have like a public jailbreak for iOS 11.2 right now are very, very small. The reason for that is that people who do create jailbreaks might keep them for themselves, and for good reason. You know, there's a lot of work in there, and yes, I'm talking about KeenLab, and they have the rights to keep their work private if they want to, and therefore the older versions are more prone to be jailbroken. I know that it's ubiquitous nowadays to update to the latest and greatest, but it's not always the case for the jailbreakers. And yes, you might be telling me, but George, I already know that. I know that I should not update my device, and I'm running an old version. Yes, you know that, but not everybody knows that, and the reason I'm saying that is I actually ran a poll and you would be very, very surprised. Let's go ahead here and see. So I asked on Twitter what is the favorite topic of anybody who's watching this, and 1.7k people have voted, and that is jailbreak updates. Then I realized a lot of people are interested in jailbreaking their device. But when I ran another poll on which version is everybody, as you can see, iOS 11.x is pretty much the most voted section in here, and then followed it up by iOS 10.3.x by 1.8k people. So a lot of people have indeed updated to iOS 11 even though they want the jailbreak, which is not good. And the reason for that is that there are currently no publicly available exploits or vulnerabilities for iOS 11.2, 11.1.2, 0.1, and so on. But for iOS 10.3.3 and lower, you are in luck. Now, the iOS version they have the least bugs or exploits available publicly is iOS 10.3.3. I give you that. But there is this one here, CVE-2017-7114, who has been pointed to me by somebody on Twitter, that is actually compatible with iOS 10.3.3. And this means that if somebody wanted to use this in a jailbreak, they can, since it is compatible with iOS 10.3.3. Of course, it's also compatible with Apple TV, macOS, and watchOS, but I doubt you're interested in these, at least from the jailbreaking standpoint. Now, it says in here that, quote, an issue was discovered in certain Apple products, iOS before 11 is affected, which means that iOS 10.3.3, 10.3.2, 10.3.1, 10.3, and even lower are affected. So if you're updating from iOS 10.3.3 saying there are no vulnerabilities and there is no exploit and nobody will create a jailbreak to iOS 11, you are pretty much losing even this CVE in here, 2017-7114, so your odds of getting a jailbreak are increasingly lower on iOS 11. Now, in other news, Tim Start did it again. Quote, just jailbroke my iPhone 4S by using Safari. Need to fix up a few things, but should be soon ready for a demo. Now, do not get overexcited. This is not going to get on public. I'm going to tell you why, but this is very good news. Apparently, there is a Safari bug or WebKit bug that he used in order to get iPhone 4S jailbroken. Now, he's not specifying the version though, but I assume iOS 9.x, so yeah. But then he followed up with this, quote, just to be clear, no public release intended, and he follows it up with, to avoid people trying to bypass iCloud lock. So yeah, I can understand that. So that's pretty much what's going on. He's actively involved in jailbreaking, although he keeps it private. At least we know that there is a vulnerability that would allow Safari to be used for a jailbreak on the iPhone 4S. For granted, not a lot of people have an iPhone 4S nowadays, and if you have an iPhone 4S, you're probably wondering why it's working so slow. Now, I'm pretty sure that TeamStar has been using, you know, publicly available vulnerabilities, so somebody who wants to get this to a newer level and, you know, just release it or make it something publicly available might be able to use the same vulnerability to achieve the same thing. But anyways, that's less important. What is important is that you should not update to iOS 11. There is a vulnerability that is available for the iOS 10.3.3. In fact, there is more than one available if you take a look, and it's definitely better than going on iOS 11.x. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. This video has been brought to you by Dr. Phone, a Wondershare product that helps you keep your device in shape. It helps you recover your data if you lose it or delete it, helps you transfer the data between iOS and Android, and even repair your iOS system if it gets damaged. So check it out in the description down below. Thanks for watching, guys. Do not forget to subscribe to stay updated. I'm GeoSnow. Peace out.